Hey everyone, in today's video we're discussing back and buttock pain and how to know exactly where it's coming from. For those who don't know me, my name is Dr. Zach Green here at Performance Sport and Spine. Therefore, in this video, we're going to show you simple and effective ways to know where your pain is coming from. First, the hip, the ball or socket joint, your femoral acetabular joint. Second, your SI joint, which people often think is a hip joint, but it's not. It's where the sacrum attaches to the pelvis. And then lastly, your lumbar spine or low back. We made this video applicable for anyone. So if you have no medical knowledge, you can still use it. Or if you're in a chiropractor or PT school, it'll also be helpful. When you're doing this though, always remember a cluster of findings, so three or four things that say the hip joint, is way more powerful than just a single symptom or finding. After you've gone through each step and figured out whether it's your hip, your SI, or your back pain, in the details below, we've listed three videos that address all those, and you can just click on the relative link to what you're dealing with and then start your treatment. First, for your hip joint. For this joint, there's three main criteria to be aware of. So number one, walking with the limp. When you walk, is your gait altered? Number two, groin pain or pain on that front side of that hip. And then lastly, is there a loss of internal rotation of the hip joint? Another effective tool is the orthopedic test called the Fader test, where you're putting the joint into flexion, adduction towards midline, and internal rotation. And this is pushing the ball into the socket. Now this test is very helpful when it's negative. If it's negative, you can be confident the hip is not causing your pain. If it's positive, it's more like a fever where it tells you that something's wrong, but doesn't tell you exactly what's wrong. Please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and then don't forget to turn on notifications. SI joint. With SI joint pain, your pain is right around here over the SI. And again, this is the SI, not the hip. One thing to know is people are often told that their SI has an upslip or downslip or it's rotated. This is the strongest joint in your body. It only moves a few degrees in any plane. And the only way it can get damaged or moved is with horrific car accidents or trauma. So again, it can get irritated with axial load or one leg pushing up or rotation, but again, it's irritated, not moving physically. So some activities such as vacuuming, running, lunges, stairs, or getting in out of your car may irritate it, and you might want to temporarily reduce those. But again, it's not moving your pelvis, it's just irritating tissue. There are some orthopedic tests that can help us with this joint called the Lasette 5, and it's best when three of the five are positive for the pain. And now we're going to cover your low back or your lumbar spine, which is the last five bones or vertebrae in your spine. With this area, there's four things to focus on. So the first is your pain is more likely on this region. Number two, bending your spine or back should reproduce your pain. So bending forward or backwards, bending to the side, right or left, and then rotating right or left should also reproduce the pain. Often pressing on the back is painful, and then thinking about what you did in the last 2 or 3 days. Did you lift something heavy? Did you kind of have this prolonged awkward posture or start some new exercise routine? Sometimes things that don't hurt can kind of predispose the back for a back pain episode in a few days. Medical red flags. Fracture. It's more common in women, people over the age of 50, people with osteoporosis or a recent history of trauma. Malignancy or cancer. People with persistent pain, unexplained weight loss, or a history of cancer. Infection. So this person might have fever, recent sepsis, which is a systemic inflammation of the whole body. They generally feel unwell, or a recent spinal procedure. And then lastly is caudate equine syndrome, which is where the lower spinal cord is getting compressed by something. It's an extremely serious medical condition, and you should seek immediate care if you think that you may have it. So the first thing is neurological deficits in your lower leg, perineal numbness, which is numbness around the groin area, and then new bladder or bowel dysfunction. Thank you for watching our evidence-based review on back pain and buttock pain and to figure out where it's coming from. If you did find this video helpful, please like it, subscribe to our channel, and then don't forget to check out our other great videos.